Hello and welcome to Business Defined. My name is Frankie Decker and I'm the Growth Marketing Consultant here at Frampos. The purpose of Business Defined is to provide useful information to clients, viewers, or those who simply may be curious so they can better understand business practices. In this episode, we're going to be covering the basics of what is marketing. No matter what product or service you have or what your intentions are, without the proper communication of your value, your customers will never know about your product and there will never be an awareness. So, with that being said, we're going to cover how can you market your business along with a couple basic marketing strategies. Right now, social media is the most powerful tool to market your business. A great way to implement social media strategy can be through photography, videos, webinars, or even directly contacting target audiences. In the past, physical ads, posters, and billboards were more beneficial to businesses. Now, social media strategy, e-commerce optimization, and influencer or affiliate marketing is the most powerful way to connect your business to your customers. In regards to e-commerce, it's very beneficial to reach your customers where they're at. Once you have a highly functionable e-commerce site available, it's vitally important to make sure your SEO optimization is at its best. E-commerce implementation can be curated through a third-party site or even a company such as Frampos. If you need help developing a high-quality, high-functioning site to sell products and even possibly services, think about reaching out to a third party to help develop your site to the best of their abilities. Nowadays, it's really simple to create a website. And unfortunately, due to high competition, you have to make sure that your website is branded correctly, has SEO optimization, and is very quick and fully functional when it comes to the payment processing of your products. If you're interested in more SEO optimizations, we will be covering that in later videos, but a great way to ensure your website is seen by your customers can be through keywords, Google Analytics, and strategic branding placements. Lastly, influencer and affiliate marketing is one of the most powerful tools a business can utilize to help expand awareness for their product. Influencer marketing is paid promotion by someone who has many followers via YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, or even TikTok to help promote your product to their followers. Due to the high amount of trust that customers place into influencers, they can be extremely beneficial to help create awareness for your business. If you are interested in contacting an influencer or affiliate marketer, they most likely have a manager or business email within their profile where you can reach out explaining your product and your goals of the partnership. To further dive deeper into examples of marketing, we're going to use an example of Abigail. The way that Abigail can utilize these channels is by creating strategic content in-house, whether it be taking photos of her clothes, partnering with a shoe company to cross-reference branding, in addition to paying an influencer marketer, or even creating graphics and ads and posters that have to do with her brand. Secondly, you can cross-reference with a complementary brand. In this example, Abigail, who owns a clothing company, cross-references branding with the shoe store. This collaboration can bring awareness to both brands while utilizing both audiences that follow those two companies. Lastly, Abigail pays an influencer marketer via Instagram to show off her clothes and recommend it to her followers. Through these three tactics of marketing, in-house social media content, and then paid promotion utilizing that content, cross-referencing with branding collaborations, and thirdly, paying an influencer or affiliate marketer, Abigail can successfully market her business. So to wrap it up, the definition of marketing is communicating the value of your product or service to your customers. Marketing primarily focuses on brand awareness and conversions, meaning communicating the value of your product to create awareness, thus creating conversions through purchases and references. I hope you've enjoyed Business Defined, and I hope that you have a better understanding of marketing as you can apply it to your business. Next time, we're going to be focused on growth marketing. And if you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe so we can better expand your knowledge when it comes to business practices. My name is Frankie Decker, and I'm the Growth Marketing Consultant here at Frampos. Thank you again, and see you next time.